فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We are in the explanation of the kitab, كتاب الصفات للإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله. We took the first hadith and now we will be taking the second hadith inshallah ta'ala. The author said, الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله، حدثنا محمد بن مخلد، حدثنا محمد بن مخلد بن حفص، محمد ابن مخلد ابن حفص السدوسي is his name، العطار. He is known as Musnad Iraq. He was the great scholar of hadith in Iraq. His kunya is Abu Abdullah Ad-Duri al-Baghdadi. A lot of scholars narrated from him. From those who narrated from him is Al-Imam Ad-Darqutni and Abu Hafs ibn Shaheen. And other than them too have narrated from him. He was a man who was known for understanding and comprehension. He was reliable in his knowledge. He was vast in his narrations. Mashhuran bid-diyana. He was well known for his religious piety. Mawsufan bil-amana. A trustworthy person. Madhkuran bil-ibadah. And he was excessively one who worshipped Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. ولذلك الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله. It was said that as Ali ibn Nasr said, سمعت حمزة بن يوسف يقول I heard Ali ibn Nasr said, I heard حمزة بن يوسف said, سألت الدارقطني, I asked Imam الدارقطني عن أبي عبد الله بن مخلد العطار. I asked him about him. فقال, he said, ثقة مأمون. He's a reliable person who's trustworthy. So Imam الدارقطني considered him a reliable and trustworthy person. Then he said, حدثنا محمد بن إسحاق الصاغاني. His name is محمد بن إسحاق الصاغاني. Abu, and his kunya is Abu Bakr. And he's an حافظ الحجة. And he's the Muhaddith of Baghdad. And he had Yazid ibn Harun, Aba Mishr, Aba Mishr, and other than them too. Al-Imam ibn Abi Hatim, he said about him, about Muhammad ibn Ishaq al-Saghani, Abu Bakr, al-Hafidh al-Hujjah, he said about him, huwa thabtun saduq. So he praised him for his dhabt, and he praised him for his integrity. So he praised him for his precision in knowledge and narration, and he also praised him for his integrity. Also, Ibn Kharash, he said the same about him. He said, "Thiqatun ma'mun." Darqutni said about him, "Thiqatun wa fawq al-thiqa." He said he's not only thiqa, he's above thiqa. And Yahya ibn Ma'in praised him. Rather, Ibn Mazahim, he said, كان أبو بكر الصاغاني يشبه بيحيى بن معين في وقته. That Muhammad ibn Ishaq al-Saghani, he resembled Yahya ibn Ma'in of his time. Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi said, كان أحد الأثبات المتقنين مع صلابة في الدين واشتهار بالسنة واتساع بالرواية. He was a person who was from the reliable individuals, who had high integrity. صَلَابَةٌ فِي الدِّينِ was very strong upon his religion, very steadfast. وَاشْتِهَارٌ بِالسُّنَّةِ that he was well known for his sunnah. He stuck to the sunnah. وَاتِّسَاعٌ بِالرِّوَايَةِ and he was vast in his narrations. وَحَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدُ بْنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ إِبْنُ إِبْرَاهِيمِ Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Ibrahim, his kunya is Abu Bakr al-Shafi'i al-Imam al-Mufid muhaddith Baghdad. He was a muhaddith of Baghdad, Iraq. A reliable person. كان ثقة ثبت. حسن التصانيف as Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi said جمع أبوابا وشيوخا. He compiled chapters and scholars. He had very good understanding. Dara-Qutni said about him ثِقَةٌ مَأْمُون. نعم. And others praised him. So he's a reliable person. And then he goes on to say, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو قَبِيصَةَ مُحَمَّدِ بْنُ عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ عَمَّارِ بْنُ الْقَعْقَعِ. And Muhammad ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Muhammad ibn Ammar ibn al-Qa'qa' is ibn Shubruma. He is ibn Shubruma. Na'am. And he was a thiqatun thabt. He was a Shafi'i al-Madhab. And Imam al-Dara-Qutni said about him, لا بأس به, there's no problem with him. Na'am. والحسين بن شاكر. حسين بن شاكر is الحسين بن عبد الله بن شاكر السمرقندي. الإمام الدارقطني weakened him. الإمام الدارقطني he weakened him. He said ضعيف. He's weak. Even that though عبد الرحمن بن محمد الإدريسي he said that كان ثقة كثير الحديث. He praised him. عبد الرحمن بن محمد الإدريسي, you praised him by saying that he's a reliable person whose narrations were vast in number. And Imam حافظ بن حجر in لسان الميزان. لسان الميزان is a work that Ibn حجر put on الميزان الاعتدال by Imam الذهبي. Ibn حجر worked on it. He called it لسان الميزان. He said الدارقطني said ضعيف. He said that he's weak. الحسين بن شاكر, he's weak. وقال إنه كان يسرق الحديث. He said that he would steal narrations. But we don't need to worry about the weakness of Al-Husayn ibn Abdullah ibn Shakirin. We know he's weak. We take the opinion that he's weak. But we don't need to worry because his narrations are backed up and it's maqroon. He has a tabi' from the other riwayat that we mentioned. The other riwayat that we mentioned, he has a tabi'. So he is maqroon in this narration. So Al-Husayn ibn Shakirin said, قَالُوا حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. The nuskha that we have right now of Abdullahi, Al-Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman, it says, what does it say for you? وَالْحُسَيْنِ ibn Shakirin قَالُوا حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. صح? It says, حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. This is wrong. That's not حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. The correct is that it is عُبَيْدُ ibn Umar. It says حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Umar. It's not Abdullah ibn Umar. It's عُبَيْدُ ibn Umar. Which عُبَيْدُ ibn Umar is it? It is عُبَيْدُ ibn Umar al-Qawariri. Do you remember him? عُبَيْدُ ibn Umar al-Qawariri is the one we took in the first narration. We took him. Who Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Aziz said إِمْلَاءً مِنْ لَفْضِهِ. He narrated it to me and dictated it to me from his own wordings. That was the first hadith. So here it's meant to be Ubaydullah ibn Umar. That is correct. Whose name is Ibn Maysarata. His kunya is Abu Sa'id al-Basriyu. He was Nazir Baghdad. He resided in Baghdad and he's a thiqatun thabt. And he's min rijali kutub sitta. As Imam al-Dhahabi, Imam Ibn Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi mentions in his Tahdhib al-Kamal. As for the rest, we've already spoken about them. حدثنا عبيد الله ابن عمر القواريري حدثنا حرمي ابن عمارة حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة عن أنس. And we took who شعبة was. شعبة ابن حجاج أبو بسطام العتكي. قتادة we took him. He's أبو الخطاب. قتادة ابن دعامة السدوسي. Who narrated from who? عن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه. عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. From the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he said, يُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ. A group of people are going to be thrown into the hellfire. وَتَقُولُ. And the hellfire will say, هَلْ مِن مَزِيدٍ. Is there any more to be added to it? Any more, any ziyada, any additional. حَتَّى يَضْعَ رِجْلَهُ. Until Allah places his leg in there. فِيهَا. In it, in the hellfire. أَوْ قَالَ قَدَمَهُ. Or unless Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, or Allah places in it his foot. فَتَقُولُ. Then the hellfire will say قَطْ قَطْ. And we said there's two ways of saying قَطْ. We can say قط بفتح القاف or we can say بكسر القاف قط. And Ibn Khuzaymah in his Kitab al-Tawheed, he mentions both riwayah, both طبط. Ibn Khuzaymah in his Kitab al-Tawheed, he mentions that you can say قط and قط, he brings both طبط, both wordings. And as I said, this is a way that the Arabs would say it. What it means is حسبي كفاني, enough, that's what it means. You see? Now here, this hadith, there's an individual who Al-Imam al-Shafi'i refuted him, and other A'immatu al-Salaf refuted him, Ahmad ibn Hanbal refuted him, and others, who was a deviated individual. And his name was Bishr al-Marisi. Bishr al-Marisi. And there's a refutation on him, a very good scholastic book on refutation on him, written by Sheikh Uthman al-Darimi, Al-Imam al-Uthman al-Darimi, rahimahullah. He wrote a book called An-Naqd 'ala Bishr al-Marisi. Huh? He wrote a book called An-Naqd 'ala Bishr al-Marisi. This book is matbu' and it's mutadawal. It's published, you can find it. This book, one of the things that Bishr al-Marisi put forward was that he said that two shubhas, two doubts he brought forward regarding this particular hadith. He said, you guys are saying, هَلْ مِن مَزِيدٍ. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is saying, so you, this hadith is saying, هَلْ مِن مَزِيدٍ. Is there any additional? Is there any additional? So this means that the hellfire is not full. That the hellfire is not full. And he said, where are you going to take the ayah? لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَا من الجنة والناس أجمعين. I'm going to fill the hellfire, Allah is saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how could the hellfire say, هل من مزيد? Imam al-Uthman al-Darimi responded to him. Imam al-Uthman al-Darimi responded to him by saying to him, just because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that He will fill the hellfire, that doesn't necessitate, and it doesn't mean that there's no space left. Just like you would say that the masjid is full, but there still could be a group of people who can still enter. You see, the word full doesn't necessarily mean always that something has reached, that nothing, so a person can still enter the masjid, or two people can still enter the masjid, three people can still enter the masjid. I can say to you, okay, I'm full, I don't want to eat. But can you still take food in? Can you still take food in? You could. After you're eating your meal, if I say to you, Akhi, do you like this ice cream? But you know you're full, you can still take something in it. So Allah feeling it doesn't necessitate that there's no room. Jahannam doesn't have no room left. The other shubha that he brought forward was that, if you say that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He places His foot, or Allah tabarak wa ta'ala places His leg in the hellfire, that would necessitate that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's leg is in the hellfire, and that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's leg is going to be punished. So Imam Uthman al-Darimi responded to him by saying to him, that also is not necessarily the case, because what we know is there are in the hellfire angels, and we also know that there are snakes and creatures inside the hellfire, but they're not being punished. They are being used to punish the ones who are in the hellfire. And how did Allah protect the angels from the punishment of the hellfire? And min hikam Allah, this is from Allah's wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we haven't perceived, and that we haven't understood. So Uthman al-Darimi said, if the creation of Allah is like this, then what do you think of the Creator, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? You will not be able to perceive it properly. There's also another point that I wanted to bring to your attention, which is this is istishhad used by Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah in Kitab al-Tawheed. Al-Imam Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah in Kitab al-Tawheed, he mentions that when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala was speaking against the idols and the aliha that the disbelievers worship, one of the things Allah tabarak wa ta'ala spoke against it by saying was what? أَلَهُمْ does the idols have? Alahum, do they have? Am lahum adanu yasma'una? Alahum arjulu yamshuna biha? Do they have legs which they walk with? One of the things Allah says that these idols that they're worshipping, do they have legs to walk with? Am lahum aydin yabtishuna biha? Do they have hands which they grab things with? Am lahum adanu yasma'una? Do they have ears which they have hear things with? And then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَ بَلْهُمْ أَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا. They're worshipping something that doesn't have an origin. Ibn Khuzaymah said, Allah is rebuking and speaking against their idols because it doesn't have legs. As a deficiency. So why would Allah تبارك وتعالى speak against it as a deficient thing and not be a characteristics of completeness for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the istishhad of who? Imam al-A'immah Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah ta'ala. Pertaining to that particular verse. Na'am. Pertaining to that particular verse. Also, we spoke about the an'ana of Qatada, right? The an'ana of Qatada, as we said, as Bardiji and others mentioned, is that as-sahhu an-nasi riwayat an Qatadata Shu'bah. Shu'bah's narrations are the best narrations that have come from Qatada. And the reason is because he would only narrate from him if they were what? If they were, they had, na'am. If they were narrations which were, na'am, free from tadlis and they were connected. حدثنا أبو الحسن محمد بن عبد الله بن زكريا النيسابوري بمصر. This is the third hadith which we're going into. أبو الحسن محمد بن عبد الله بن زكريا النيسابوري بمصر. He narrated. He said, حدثنا أبو عبد الرحمن أحمد بن الشعيب النسائي. This is Imam النسائي رحمه الله. أبو عبد الرحمن أحمد بن الشعيب النسائي is Imam النسائي رحمه الله تعالى. One of the scholars who wrote the six books of hadith which we take. Imam al-Nasa'i said, أخبرنا محمد ابن عمر ابن علي ابن مقدم ابن مقدم حدثنا أشعث ابن عبد الله حدثنا شعبة عن قتادة عن أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يلقى في النار وتقول هل من مزيد حتى يضع رجله أو قدمه فتقول قط قط. This is another. So what you can see is Imam Ad-Darqutni rahimahullah, he's bringing different other riwayat and different other narrations to strengthen the previous narrations if you find any deficiency in it. So all of these narrations, they go back to who? Shu'bah, Qatada and Anas radiallahu ta'ala. Isn't that case? Okay. حدثنا علي بن عبد الله بن ميسرة. This narration it says, حدثنا علي بن عبد الله بن ميسرة. علي بن عبد الله بن ميسرة. This is what you find in the matbu, the published versions of the book. And that's what it says right now in the copy of Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman's version. He says, حدثنا علي بن عبد الله بن ميسرة. If you go back to the manuscript, you find it is also the same, which is علي بن عبد الله بن ميسرة. And that is not the case, it is wrong. وصوابه correct is علي بن عبد الله بن مبشر. That is the correct name. If you go to the طبقات الشافعية الكبرى by Subki, the third volume, page 463, and you look at the tarjama, the biography of Imam Ad-Darqutni, that it mentions that he narrated from an individual by the name of Ali ibn Abdullah ibn Mubashir. And if you look at also his tarjama of Imam Dhahabi before him, you find that he mentions Ali ibn Abdullah ibn Mubashir, Abu al-Hassan al-Wasiti al-Muhaddith. So this individual, Ali ibn Abdullah ibn Maysarat al-Wasiti, is not Maysarat, is Mubashir. And the reason why that mistake came is because of the issue of the dots. Very good. He says, حدثنا أبو الأشعث أحمد بن المقدام المقدام أبو الأشعث أحمد ابن المقدام. And he is, as Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions in his taqrib, he is saduq, reliable person, صاحب حديث, a scholar of hadith. Even that though Abu Dawood and Naysaburi criticized him for his muru'ah, his integrity, his honor. Huh? You know, muru'ah was what? What would be the... Ha! He criticized him for it. Na'am. He then said, حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدْ إِبْنُ عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ الطُّفَارِيُّ الطُّفَاوِيُّ Sorry. الطُّفَاوِيُّ حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدْ إِبْنُ عَبْدِ الرَّحْمَنِ الطُّفَاوِيُّ And Muhammad ibn Abd al-Rahman al-Tufawi, as Hafiz ibn Hajar mentioned in his taqrib, he said, Suduq yahimu. He's a reliable person, but he does wahm sometimes. Falls into shortcomings. The rest we don't need to worry about. The rest are Rijal al-Isnad, Thiqat al-Athbat. The rest are reliable, and they are reliable, of high integrity. Who then said, Haddathana Ayyub. Ayyub here is Abu Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, Abu Tamim. An Muhammad. The Muhammad here is Muhammad ibn Sirin, Abu Bakr al-Basriyu, the great Tabi'i. And you know Muhammad ibn Sirin was a mawla li Anas ibn Malikin. Anas had him as a slave, Muhammad ibn Sirin. You see? An Muhammad, an Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who narrated from Abu Huraira, Abdul Rahman ibn Sakhrin. His name, they disputed it on many, many different names, as Ibn Abdul Barr mentions. I think he said 40 different khilafat has come. But the strongest is that his name is Abdul Rahman ibn Sakhr. Who then said, Ani Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the messenger said, Ikhtasamatil jannatu wal nar. The jannah and the nar, they quarreled. Faqalatil naru, the nar said, يَدْقُلُنِي الْجَبَابِرَةُ وَالْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ The hellfire said, يَدْخُلُنِي الْجَبَابِرَةُ وَالْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ The tyrant and the arrogant ones enter me. Some of the nusakhs, some of the copies, it says, وَالْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ That's what it says. If you look at the أصل النسخة المخطوطة, it says متكبرين, and that's incorrect grammatically. لأن المتكبرون is عطف and it is connected to the فعل that's before it which is الجبابرة يدخلني الجبابرة the جبابرة enter me والمتكبرون is correct because the واو is عطف واو العطف and the عطف is from the توابع so it follows the sign of that which was before it صحيح so it's correct to say والمتكبرون وقالت الجنة and the جنة said يدخلني ضعفاء الناس وسقطهم. The Jannah then said, the weak ones and the low graded ones are going to enter me. Very good. فقال الله جل وعز للنار Allah responded to the hellfire and he said, أنت عذابي, you are my punishment. أصيب بك من أشاء. I punish you with whoever I wish. وَقَالَ لِلْجَنَّةِ Allah then says to the Jannah, أَنْتَ رَحْمَتِي You are my mercy. أُصِيبُ بِكِ مَنْ أَشَاءُ I bless you with whoever I wish, I will. وَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ وَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِنْكُمَا مِلْؤُهَا And each and every one of you has its full. I will fill it up. Each and every one of you is going to have his fill. فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ When it's the day of judgment, لَمْ يَظْلِمِ اللَّهَ Allah is not going to oppress أَحَدًا a person. مِنْ خَلْقِهِ شَيْئًا He's not going to oppress any of his creation in anything whatsoever. وَيُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ وَتَقُولُ And a people will be thrown into the hellfire, who are the people of the hellfire. وَتَقُولُ And then the hellfire will say, هَلْ مِن مَزِيدٍ Is there any additional? حَتَّى يَضَعُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى عَلَيْهَا قَدَمُهُ. Until Allah places in it His foot. فَهُنَاكَ and then تَمْتَلِئُ. The hellfire fills up. وَتَنْزَوِي بَعْضُهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ. And the sides of the hellfire come together. وَتَقُولُ and then it says, قَطْ, enough. أخرجه مسلم, الإمام مسلم narrated this. عن عبد الله بن عون, who is who? ابن أرطان. ابن أرطيان, whose name is ابن أرطيان. نعم, عن أبي سفيان المعمري. And in the nuskha of Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman, what does it say? عن أبي سفيان المعمري, هي ابن محمد ابن حميد, right? That ابن محمد is incorrect. That ابن is not there. Because the riwayah, he said, أخرجه مسلم, right? When you go to the asal of the kitab, Sahih Muslim, and you check, you realize that it is what? عن سفيان المعمري محمد بن حميد. And not ابن محمد بن حميد. Who narrated from عن معمر. معمر, his name, his kunya is أبو عروة معمر بن راشد الأزدي. That's who معمر is. His kunya is أبو عروة. He's معمر بن راشد and he's from الأزدي. عن أيوب, we said أيوب السختياني أبو تميم. عن محمد, we said محمد بن سيرين أبو بكر البصري. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه, from أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه. هكذا this way.